We're joined now by the Chief Executive of Anglesey Mining, Bill Hooley. Bill, welcome.
Good morning.
It's a very interesting conference here this year at Mines and Money, and a lot's gone into discussions about the markets and so forth.
Absolutely.
One of those markets, of course, in which you operate, the iron ore market. Tell us a little bit about what Anglesey's got.
Yes, we operate in two markets, one of which is base metals, copper, lead, zinc in North Wales, and the other significant one at this point in time is the iron ore market. With our 20% holding in Labrador Iron Mines, which obviously is in Canada.
Mm. How's that going? Because we've seen a fair hefty drop in the price of iron ore. You are producing there, aren't you?
We very much are producing. I mean, it's been a good year. It's been our first full year of production. 2011 we started off, but it was only a half year. And we produced about 400,000 tonnes last year. But this year we've produced 1.7 million tonnes. Mm. We've railed that to the port, and that has all been sold. So it's been a good year. It's got it, the mine is up to production capacity, and it's operating very, very well. The disappointing part, of course, has been a very sharp fall in the iron ore price during the months of August and September. There has been a recovery since then, but that hurt us quite badly, there was no doubt, and we had three of our 10 shiploads in that very low price, and that caused us an operating loss for that quarter, which we've reported. But the price is back up again, and we're hoping that the worst is behind us as far as that is concerned.
You should say you're 20% interest in that project,
indeed,
aren't you?
Yes, yeah. We were instrumental in that company being floated on the Toronto Stock Exchange in 2007. We were diluted, obviously, at that that IPO down to 50%, and with some subsequent financings, we've now been diluted down to a 20% level, or just under 20%. But that's a very comfortable position for us, and under 20% actually gives us a little more freedom to trade that stock than it would have done over 20%,
sure,
where we would have been bound by a number of Canadian regulations.
Yeah.
So we're freed of that at the moment.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
We're, it's a comfortable position for us at the moment.
Let's talk about the copper lead zinc
sure.
project in Parys Mountain,
yes,
because there's been some recent news about that. I know the scoping study is underway, isn't it?
Scoping study is underway, yes. We put a new JORC resource out last week. This project has been around for a long, long while. I mean, the project started in Bronze Age times. I wasn't there then, but in its modern incarnation, the company has been around since 1988.
Right.
One of the great things it did during that period was get planning permissions for the whole operation, all of which are still in place, so we do not have to go through that step. We have now updated all of our resources. The ones that were produced during that period following the initial work were of historic nature. They weren't modern compliant type resources. That has now been brought up to date. I think it supported the old numbers. We're very happy with the way they've come together. We're happy that part of the resource review has been able to make one of a whole series of smaller intersections into a decent ore body now, one of the other ore bodies. But the two main ore bodies that we're going to start off are in good grade, so one of them, the first one, is about 7% combined metal,
right,
and then we'll lead into another one with about 9% combined metal, but more of that is copper, so it's a higher grade.
Mm.
So we're very pleased with the way that's gone. The scoping study, as we have indicated, is being prepared. It's not very far away, and we hope that we'll get that in the next few weeks. And in the new year, we'll be looking at how we finance this and how we develop it.
Yeah. How do you see those markets at the moment? It's another theme of this conference, isn't it, is the capital markets for mining companies.
Oh, capital markets are very difficult. There's no doubt about that. But I think we're going to have to be a little bit clever about how we finance this. I'm not sure that we will necessarily come to the equity markets for finance. I think we'll look at diverse funding. We'll look at particularly, I think we'll look at some offtake funding for perhaps some smelters or traders. We will be producing a zinc concentrate out of this mine. If we can get going next year, we'll be producing that zinc concentrate by 2014, 2015, when it's forecast that there will be a shortage of zinc concentrate, particularly into the European market. And I think our timing could be good, and I think that could make a number of smelters and traders interested in our product for financing purposes.
Well, that's the next question, is where is it going to end up going? I mean, you're not too far away from a port, are you?
Oh, no, we are just about 20 miles away from the port. Obviously, it's in the UK, all of the infrastructure's in place, we don't have to build roads. We're not going to be moving a huge amount of concentrate, it's not going to be disrupting anybody. It'll go out of the port of Holyhead. The typical markets are going to be in the Baltic or in the Rhine or in Spain. So it's a very short shipping. That's the least of the problems of this project. But it's a very handy position to be in.
Yeah. So investors looking at this for 2013, obviously they're going to kick off first of all, with the scoping study. That's
yes.
The thing.
Yeah, well,
what are the milestones are you looking for?
Well, I think we're then going to be looking at how we finance it and then hopefully moving it into development, starting some mining up on Parys Mountain again. It'd be nice to see. It's been a 24 years or something since anything's happened up there.
In the meantime, Labrador just keeps on...
Labrador will keep operating. I mean, it is a seasonal business. We have closed down the operation now. It's very cold. It's already minus 25 up at the mine. So we can't rail ore out during these winter periods. So we sent our last shipment out a week ago. We will commence operations again in the back end of March. And we will continue to keep our interest in that. But it's more of a passive interest. But,
good.
We think it's going to be a positive year for Labrador next year.
We'll look forward to that. And Bill, good luck, and thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much.
That's Bill Hooley, Chief Executive of Anglesey Mining.